So many things are changing. I'm in a world that's breaking my heart. Hey, Nurse Bae. Welcome back to my channel. It's your girl Mel. So today I want to talk about five things I wish I would have knew before becoming a nurse. Better yet, five things I wish I would have knew before becoming a LPN. Now I wanted to really come out with this video because I've been getting all type of questions. People want to know how my life has changed since I've been a nurse, but a lot of people are not asking why I became a nurse and the things I wish I would have knew before I became a nurse. So sit back, get you a snack, get you some water, get comfortable, because I'm gonna tell you all the tea, okay? So watch this video to the end, subscribe right now so we can get that out the way. Come with me on this journey because I'm gonna tell y'all what's really going on behind the scenes. So come on with me. So the first thing I want to talk about is becoming a CNA, a STNA, or a tech before you become a nurse. This is not only going to give you experience, but it's also going to allow you to be a team player in these situations at the nursing home. Another thing I know they didn't tell you is that you will not have time to do nothing personally for yourself. Half the time you will have to eat at the nurse station. You will have to hold your pee for long periods of time. And you must get your work done before the end of your shift unless you want to stay over. I wanted to show y'all some new IV pumps that they have out. Just in case you haven't seen it, this is the new Gravity Collection Kit for IV administration. And to be honest, with an IV added onto the med pass is way too much. So I had to do a bladder scan on my patient. So I wanted to show y'all some of the stuff that comes in the kit, because I know they did tell y'all about this in nursing school, but this is something that you will have to do in real life. Putting a Foley in a woman is really hard. Putting a Foley in a man is not that hard. When I bladder scanned him, he had like 800 in his bladder. So I had to change his catheter and the Foley bag and all of that. And y'all, it didn't even work because his prostate was enlarged. So I ended up having to send him to the hospital, which really worked for me because I just sent him out 911, because it's not no way you got 800 in your bladder and you can't relieve it, and I'm gonna let you sit here and wait for transportation. So another thing I know they are not mentioning in nursing school is that you may have to call the doctor or send somebody out to the hospital, and you may have to call 911. You may have to call transport. It's just a different scenario for different situations, so it's up to you to figure that out. I will be addressing in this video, because I feel like you deserve to get the best out of your new situations coming into a nursing facility, a rehab, or anything of that nature. This video, as you keep watching, is going to help you to be able to be more prepared in situations when you're going to look around and you're the one that's in charge.
School is the fact that you may come after a nurse, they may get an admission 2 to 3 hours before and not even touch the resident. They may not even touch the patient. Sometimes you're going to be dealing with lazy nurses, lazy workers that don't do their work, and when you get reported, they'll skip over the stuff they didn't do, and you won't know until they leave what you have to do after them because they dropped the ball. But one thing that they do tell you in nursing school is that you cannot throw them under the bus. At no time can you be like, you cannot document this nurse should have did this, I did this. No, always document what you did, because what you did is very important. Never consider what somebody else did, because because at all times somebody could be dropping the ball, but it's up to you to handle it, to dribble it, to shoot it. So one thing they never tell you in nursing school is how lazy your workers, your staff, the people you're going to follow are. So it gets crazy. Sometimes you have to work with the CNAs. It's going to be time where you may have to change somebody. It's going to be times where you got to answer the call lights. You got to pass the meds. You got to call the doctor. You got to do all these things. So learning how to multitask is going to be your number one focus and prioritizing your work. That's how you're going to get stuff done. And if you don't do something, let people know. That's how we're going to continue patient safety. This is the stuff that they don't tell you in nursing school, them family members.
I'm sorry. We need somebody 135. She needs a pain pill.
I gave her a pain pill, sir. I can't give her the insulin. I can't give her the insulin.
We have to have a nurse. She needs a insulin to cover her meal.
Okay, sir. I'll be down there.
You said you gave her a pain pill?
Yes, I gave her a pain pill already. I gave her a pain pill when I was just in there, sir. When I just came in there, I gave her a pain pill. Okay. I don't have anything else to give her right now. I'll be in there about 30 minutes.
30 minutes? She has to cover her meal with insulin.
Okay, sir. I understand that, but I don't understand what happened where y'all told the supervisor y'all didn't want the insulin.
You already gave her five units. She hadn't had a meal.
Okay, sir, I'm sorry, but I will be down there. Okay.
Who else do I have to talk to?
Maybe you could talk to the supervisor, but I don't know. I'll have to find her. I'll tell her to come down there. So the person, the patient that I just told you, like, her husband just came up here and was like, she needs her pain medicine, she needs her insulin, she can't wait. So I'm like, I just gave her her pain medicine. Y'all told me she didn't want the insulin. He like, well, I'm trying to figure out what are we waiting for. I am putting a new admissions order on the computer. I'm like, I'll be down there in like 15 minutes. I'll have the supervisor come. He like, well, we can't wait 15 minutes. Where's the supervisor? So basically, a situation just happened where a resident's family member, her husband, comes to me and asks me about insulin. The insulin that I was supposed to give them, they didn't want it at dinner time. So instead of me giving them the insulin, they refused it and they told me they wanted a copy of her orders. So I went to go give the lady a copy of her order in time because, mind you, I have 20-something residents that I'm dealing with. So in the midst of all of this, she also brings for a pain pill. A pain pill, right? So I go give her the pain pill. They tell me they want to see the supervisor because the medications is not right. She's not supposed to be getting the insulin this early before dinner, which was only like 15 minutes before dinner, okay? So the lady proceeds to check her own Accu-Chek an hour later and tells me she needs insulin. Let's make it make sense. And then they also tell me that she needs a pain pill when I've already given her a pain pill. So I'm sitting here charting, minding my business, y'all. Minding my business. Okay? This man, he comes in the nurse station and he's like, who's the manager on call? Who's the supervisor on call? Who can I talk to? Because she needs her insulin. She needs her pain meds. Sir. Pause. What do you mean right now? I've done everything that I can. I'm sorry. But I'm doing something right now. I will be with you in 10 to 15 minutes. This man said 10 to 15 minutes. We can't wait that long. We can't wait that long. My wife's not about to wait that long. Okay, I'll call the supervisor. The supervisor tells me to finish up what I'm doing and then go check her sugar on our Accu-Chek machine. Y'all, this is the stuff that they don't tell you in nursing school. Them family members.
Fast when you do what you want. At this time, doing what I want. But she don't love me, she too scary. My hope is fun like Jackie Brown. I wanna love but she too down. Will you be my leading lady? I wanna contract, get no maybe. In the meantime, just some me time. I'll be doing what you want. By the beast like Odell. Oh, over more, my killers don't tell.
Okay, so one thing they probably will never tell you in nursing school is that sometimes in nursing and when you become a new nurse, life will get away from you. And it's only because, like, all these 12-hour shifts that we be doing, these 16-hour shifts that we be doing, the money do be hidden. But it's very hard because you have to learn a balance between life and work. Because all of the money that you making, it means nothing if you don't make no memories. So right now in my life, I'm really trying to, you know, be more present in my life and take advantage of the time that I'm off work. So today I'm a little dragging. The night shift life, it really be hidden because you always are going to be able to get a shift differential when you work a night shift. They may not tell you in nursing school that day shift is going to always make less money than evening shift, and night shift is always going to make the most money. But don't get caught up in the night shift life. Enjoy your time off. And if you do gotta hustle, hustle. By all means, make your money, but don't let time pass you by. Thank y'all for watching this video to the end. Please subscribe to my channel. Comment below any videos that you feel that you want me to address, any questions that you have. I'm going to put my email in the description and give this video a thumbs up for you to see more content like this in the future. Until next time, bye.